Hi all, this is Dr. O, and in this video we're going to talk about the temporomandibular joint. And specifically, what type of joint is the temporomandibular joint, and what actions occur at this joint?
So let's start with talking about what makes up the TMJ, or the temporomandibular joint. The bony portions we discussed in the last video, we can see are the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone, and the condylar process that sits nicely within it from the mandible, and then that articular tubercle found anterior to both. The other important part of this joint is going to be that articular disc. So this is a disc of fibrocartilage, and it acts to actually separate the joint cavity into two specific compartments. Now this is why I've got in very italicized large word here, modified. So a hinge joint, you can typically think of an elbow where you can extend and flex at the elbow. In the TMJ, what we see actually are four movements, and this is enabled by that articular disc kind of modifying the joint and allowing for more movements to take place. So before we watch this, let's take a look and do some palpation. So go ahead and put your hands on your temporomandibular joint and actually open your mouth to a certain point and then open a little wider and then back. So what you feel is that mandibular condyle. At first, you can feel kind of the movement of it just kind of rocking within that fossa, and then you see it come forward. So let's see how this looks in this really wonderful animation we can see here. So we've got the disc lit up in orange shown right here. So from a lateral view, you can see how that condyle actually moves and glides along. So we see some movement like a hinge and then the gliding as well. All right, so let's break down those different movements. So if we start from a closed position, we start to open the mouth, we need to do depression. So depression is kind of moving in an inferior direction. So you depress your shoulders when you push them down your back. So depression of the TMJ is opening of the mouth. So we see depression in that mandibular condyle stays in the place of the mandibular fossa along the way. Then what we see is called protraction. So protraction, also known as protrusion, is movement in an anterior-posterior plane. So we see now how that is moving away from where it originally was, more anteriorly. To close then, we need to undo the motions that we had done, which will start with retraction, bringing it back into the mandibular fossa, and then elevation, closing the mouth. So what happens is actually these hinge movements are happening within the inferior compartment. So depression and elevation are within the inferior compartment, and then the superior compartment is where we see that gliding taking place, that protraction and retraction enabled by that articular disc.
When we're considering the neurovasculature of a joint, we can think about it being opportunistic. So what we see is that specific structures that pass around the area or supply muscles in the area will also supply that joint. So the major sources we're seeing here are auriculotemporal nerve, which takes afferent innervation from the area, and blood supply through the maxillary and the superficial temporal arteries. So let's take a look at this in 3D. So we have represented here a lot of the vasculature and the nerves to the area. Now that is the superficial temporal artery and the maxillary artery. And the nerve lit up there is the auriculotemporal nerve. And you'll see how close in proximity these are to the temporomandibular joint.
All right, so our question is, a dislocation of the TMJ is typically through the gliding movements or the translational movements. So which compartment of the synovial cavity is involved in these movements? So take a moment to choose your answer. And when you're ready, let's talk about it. So when we're talking about the gliding motions, that is our superior compartment. So the answer here is A, the superior compartment. And you can see how this has moved forward. So that is protraction that will then retract back into the mandibular fossa with closing of the mouth. The inferior compartment is where we see the hinge joint movements happening, so elevation and depression. Great, that's everything for this video. Thank you so much, and let me know if you have any questions at all.